अस्सलाम वालेकुम रेस्पेक्टेड चेयर डेलीगेट्स कैलाश जी, योगेश जी, इरफान साहब, अदर पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑफ दिस सेमिनार, थैंक यू अफरोजी फॉर कॉलिंग मी हियर. एक्चुअली दिस इज द एक्सटेंडेड पेपर ऑफ योगेश जी. एक्चुअली मेरा टॉपिक थियोरेटिकल स्टेट वर्सेस सेक्युलर स्टेट स्ट्रेटजीज ऑफ अपकमिंग जनरल इलेक्शंस. आधा पार्ट तो आपने बोल दिया है. अब थियोरेटिक स्टेट का पार्ट मैं समझता हूँ दो और तीन मिनट में हो जाएगा. एंड वी नो दिस थियोरेटिक स्टेट स्टेटस ऑफ द कंट्री इज ऑलरेडी इमर्ज्ड एंड इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 2014 इटसेल्फ. हाफ ऑफ द इंडिया एंड नॉर्दर्न इंडिया हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड फाउंडेड बाय द संघ परिवार फैमिली. Sangh Parivar and the Manusmriti model of governance, rather constitutional model of governance, has been implementing right to the first day of the government of this present regime. And this Manusmriti model of governance, despite legitimacy through legislation, this mobocracy has been established or legitimacy has been given to the mobocracy, while the non-state actors has been emerged as a legitimate actors of the state. Some of the presenters actually in morning panel discussion, Ajay Gurvarti was stated that there are the two sides of this populism. One is the public side, another is the private side. So this is the public side has been established, and through this, you know, the non-state actor. So this is the controversial political journey of the BJP, when our media sources, and it has been established fact that how recently Anand Kumar Hegde of Karnataka has criticized the word secular and said that the BJP government would amend the constitution to remove the word from the preamble. So what is it? If it is removed, it will be removed from the constitution. So the constitution will become as a Manusmriti, half of the Manusmriti as it is in implementing till 2018. It will be, I think it will be fully removed, the version, till 2019. It's a biggest threat to the secular state. And this is not the statement of the Anand Kumar Hegde. This is actually policy statement of the union government, it seems. And another union minister, Riju, stirred a controversy with the remark that the population of the Hindus in India was going down as they never convert people, while minorities are flourishing unlike some other countries. This is another controversial statement given by the union minister, Riju. And another controversial lawmaker, Sakshi Maharaj, Remain News, making controversial remarks in order to increase the population of Hindus in the nation, and asked Hindu women to produce at least 4 kids each to counter the Muslim population. This is another controversial statement of Sakshi Maharaj ji, and another popular man of Sangh Parivar, Giriraj Singh. This is another example of theocratic state. He made controversial remark on one after another. BJP during the Lok Sabha elections called Modi's critics as Pakistanis. Those who oppose Prime Minister candidate Narendra Modi should leave India, as their place will be Pakistan. Although he is very close to Modi, but the series making contentious remarks did not stop here and added fuel into another statement, the Niranjani Jyoti controversy, by comparing Modi to Lord Ram. So this is the another milestone towards a theocratic state till 2019. See, my argument is half of the India has become theocratic state. Northern India has been converted from into the Manusmriti model of governance. Yes, another Mohan Mohan Bhagwat, the CEO Prime Minister of India. I'm sorry to say, off the record. So RSS chief Mohan Bhagwat leave no stone unturned to call India as a Hindu Rashtra. RSS is BJP's parent organization, cultural organizations, and party never instigate to stop this PM Narendra Modi is put into mouth soldier. He can be always seen in the fetching Hindutva identity to the nation when he stated. So, quote unquote, Hindustan is a Hindu nation and Hindutva is the identity of our nation. And Hinduism can incorporate others, religious in itself. He always remains in the news for sole reason, that is the converting secular nation into the Hindutva nation. This is another theocratic model of India. Another controversial remark. These are all not the controversial statements. This is the governance model of Manusmriti of the Sangh Parivar government. Sadhvi Prachi. Another controversial statement, making India Muslim free. India Muslim free. Prachi, a VHP leader, not at all a BJP full-time leader, but he pro-Hindutva rhetoric has been an embarrassment to the party sometimes. She has called for making India Muslim free, announced a reward of 50 lakhs rupees to any person who will behead Islamic preacher Zakir Naik, and wishes to boycott Shah Rukh Khan as his well-being Muslim. Okay. And another theocratic state model of governance or Manusmriti model of governance, whose statement, Sadhvi Niranjan Jyoti, a popular, not popular, controversial comment, Haramzadeh. It was a rally in West Delhi, Shyam Nagar, the BJP's Union Minister Sadhvi Niranjan Jyoti asked voters to choose Ramzadeh or Haramzadeh. Ramzadeh or Haramzadeh, this is another embarrassment to the nation, not to the BJP. Yes. So this is the model of Manusmriti model of governance, and I am concluding, sir. So another point of my paper is, when the BJP has the tall promises made in its manifesto, but the manifesto is not at all a model of governance, but 2014 to 2018, it was the real manifesto they have done in a practical way. So if you see the 2014 results, if you see the tally of alliance of 2014, BJP, NDA got 336, 59 for UPA and 145 for others. I have tallied for just an opinion poll through my personal opinion that in 2019, most probably in October, Lok Sabha can be dissolved until December elections can become through the One Nation, one as the slogan is coming through popular by the Modi government and present regime, that one nation, one election, how can it be possible, how Election Commission of India can conduct elections without proper preparations, and it will not be possible till 2024. It has been given the statement by the ECI, but how somehow now ECI has, after seeing this all MLA's disqualification of this, I think the ECI can be compelled to conduct one nation, one elections. So my conclusion is that, sir, 2019 elections will be fought between the two ideologies. One is secular ideologies, another is non-secular ideologies. One is theocratic alliances, and another is Congress alliances or secular alliances or the non-theoretical alliances. So in my opinion, what can be happened, that BJP can lose the allied parties. TDP can lose in Andhra Pradesh, and already she is in a last breakaway the alliance in Maharashtra, and here friendly relations with the TRS and some other parties in some parts of the country. So through all these opinion, the non-secular alliance, BJP plus Shiromani Akali Dal, LJP and TDP, if TDP, if you put the TDP into that account of BJP, 125 MPs can be the tally of this 2019 elections. The secular alliance, the Congress alliance, INC, Indian National Congress, NCP, RJD, I am taking JDU into the Congress account now, so it will be a controversy, or it could be a disputed thing, but it could be, because the JDU party is very clever. Somebody has said that the cat on the wall, and Nitish Kumar can do, can walk, can jump, and anything. So IUML, JMM, TMC, and CPI. So the probable tally of 2019 election result could be 320 MPs in coming Lok Sabha elections in 2019. Other parties could be 100 MPs, so it could be tally of the 543. So this will be a great fight between the ideological group, between theoretical state and the secular state. Thank you very much.